Yeah. Namaste. This is Dr. Swati, and I'm here to share some of my views about Learn Better from practicals. So I'm working as Dr. Associate Professor in the Department of Pharmaceutical Chemistry. So how to learn better from practicals? This is what we are going to discuss now. Okay. So from the childhood, you might have seen, or you might have learned many of the theory concepts. So how these concepts were utilized in your life? Just you can take a moment and think about it. Is practical is very much important. Okay, so if you want, you can pause the video and think and write in your course journal whether these practicals are important to you or not. So if you are already written, then you can replay the video. Okay, so here is my answer. Yes, practicals are very much important, particularly for professionals. Okay, because in theory, we might have come across with many concepts, many theories, okay? But we will be remembering only those concepts what we practiced in real time, okay? Because practicals, they improve our understanding of a subject, okay? There may be lot, hundreds of theories we have studied, but only 10 we practiced. So that much only we will be remembering well, okay? So that is the importance of practicals. So theoretical reasoning is concerned with the deciding what to believe. But coming to practicals, practical reasoning is concerned with deciding what and how to do. Okay. For example, there is a reaction, so-called reaction, you might have studied in various stages. Okay. And in first year B pharmacy also, you'll be doing such type of reactions. Many of such type of reactions. Okay. For example, by the reaction of a carboxylic acid with an amide, the product expected is amide. Okay, so you can take a number of carboxylic acids and you can make them to react with number of amides so that we get a number of amides. But for the synthesis of an amide, the procedure involved may be different. It depends on the type of amide, types of the reactants that we are selecting. Theory wise, there is only one such concept, that is reaction of carboxylic acid always gives us reaction with amine, always gives us amine. But practically, there may be hundreds of procedures available to get a particular amide. So that is how practical reasoning is concerned with deciding what and how to do. So always theory and practical must go hand in hand. So let us have a glance of this. So whatever we hear, generally we forget. Of course, there is an exemption. If we have hear some gossips, we may remember that well. That is different story. So I'm talking about subject only, because here only ears are involved, you can see, in hearing. Okay. Now coming to see, whatever we see, we remember. For example, movies, we remember because our eyes are involved in that. Okay. So here only eyes and mind is involved, and here ears and mind is involved. Okay. Now coming to the last aspect, that is do and understand. Okay. So what happens in this third case is we hear whatever the instructor gives us information or instructions, and we see whatever we are going to do, and we will try to understand through that act. So do and understand. By understanding the concept, we can, by doing the concept, we can understand the concept very well. So that is the importance of practicals. Just by listening and seeing, we can't understand the concept, but by doing such act, we will remember it very well. Okay. For example, in organic chemistry first year, you might have come across many of the ions and their colored reactions in the qualitative analysis. Okay, so whenever a compound is substituted for flame, depending on the cation present in it, it gives a characteristic light whenever you are substituting it for flame. For example, sodium gives yellow color, potassium gives violet color, calcium brick red, and copper bluish green color. So you might have aware of this, but not only these four ions are present, there are many ions present in inorganic pharmaceuticals. So they emit a characteristic color when they are exposed to flame. Okay, but this long charts and tables, it is very difficult to remember. But the same thing, if you do practically, for example, when you subject a compound for flame, if it is giving yellow color, means that is sodium. Similarly, if it is giving violet color, you may assume it as potassium. And similarly, if it is giving brick red color, then you can say it is calcium. And similarly, if it is giving bluish green color, based on that you can say the compound may be, the cation present may be copper. So like that, if you do the experiment, you will try to remember all those colors in your mind. So accordingly, you will be reproducing the same in your examination. Okay. So there is a small comic here given. So this dog name is Spot, and he was his master. This person is the neighbor. So this master was saying, I have taught Spot to whistle. He was telling that I taught him how to whistle. Then the neighbor was telling, I can't hear him whistling. Okay, I never heard him whistling. Then the master said, I told you that I taught him whistling, but it doesn't mean that he learned that technique. That means whatever we teach, we listen without understanding the concept. That is, without doing the practicals, will not stay in our mind. So if the same thing, if we practice, same concept, if we practice, that will be retained in our mind. So that is what the meaning of this comment. So, the main objectives of the practicals anywhere in any field is developing skills. How? That depends on different strategies. Okay? And for in order to develop skills, the most prerequisite is to understanding the theory. We need to understand the concept on which we are working. We are doing practicals. So, with the concept available in the theory, we can develop the skill by practicing it many times. So, these two are not enough. So whatever we understand, we practice it. And being a pharmacist, we have to look into the thing how these developed skills are related to our field, our pharmacy field. And after relating it to the field, it is very, very important to not to stop there, but to practice the same skills, whatever we have learned, with the steps involved. For example, if any experimentation is given, don't look as it as a single task. You divide, for the simplification purpose, you have to divide into small steps. And each and every point, you just see whether all those steps are done or not, so that the practical or the experimentation will be completed. So these are the four things. With understanding of the theory, we need to develop the skills, and we have to see its relevance to the pharmacy, and we have to practice with those skills with the steps involved. So these are the few things related to the practicals. So thank you. Followed by this video, there will be two LBDs given. Kindly answer those LBD questions. Thank you.